What's up, guys? This is Champ, and welcome back to another Mad Ultimate Team episode. This time, it has finally happened. We are on the PS4. I've been playing a little bit of the Xbox One as I've been waiting for this one to download, and I kind of decided I'm going to be doing both consoles this year, honestly. We'll just see. PS4 will probably be my main NFL one. Select your uniform so, let's start our PS4 Ultimate Team.
Now that you have a uniform, select your first team style.
Let's go, Mandy.
You have opened your team style pack. These players increase your selected style, but only if they're in your lineup.
Okay, Trey. I think we got Trey Owens last time. I think that's just the standard one you get.
For play action and will match up better one-on-one against the receivers.
How do I continue? I continue with options. Okay. You should get some free packs here, I believe, now too, right?
Every time you enter Ultimate Team, you will be dropped off on objectives will give you the tools to collect, upgrade.
Okay. Open welcome pack, generate best lineup, play a solo challenge.
Open our
best lineup here. Or open our welcome pack, I mean. It's 50 coins, you might as well do it. Get that over with, we'll complete one of the challenges there. See what we can get in it. This is one of the Madam Tips, we can throw that in the set. Alrighty. See what we can get in. I don't think you can get anything crazy in the welcome packs. Chris Conley, that's not too bad though. Okay. Gridiron Surveyor Super Deluxe Edition Weekly Packs. So we get all pro packs every week, apparently. I guess that's how it works. So you get a pack every week. And this is our first all pro pack. So let's, I guess we have to back out, maybe? Play Madden 15 on the PlayStation 4 system. Mutt 16 Loyalty. I think I have to back out and go to that, though. We got our Bo Jackson, which I also got on Xbox. So we got a back. I think we had to go to packs now to be able to see those ones. Generate best lineup, play solo challenge. I'm just gonna quickly. Let's just see if the packs are there. Yeah, they are there. I'm gonna do the best lineup now, just because all of these players that we have right now aren't auctionable. So I might as well do the best lineup while I have these guys, and then I can just start building my team later on here. So go like that, and then we'll back out, and we'll go check out these packs. I'm interested to see what's in that all-pro pack, but we gotta check out the Playmaker pack first. See what we get in this one. Okay, 89 Odell Beckham Jr. That is, these are one of the rewards, though. So Playmaker, this limited-time player becomes a 70 overall on September 25th. That's still pretty good. That's still a month of Odell Beckham with 92 speed, 94 catch, 94 spectacular catch, 93 route running. Just crazy stats across the board. I got Peterson, actually, on my Xbox version. But that's still a really cool card. Awesome. Love that Odell Beckham. We'll actually promote him right now because, again, he's not sellable either. So we'll throw him in the lineup. Oh, that doesn't really matter too much. So we have an All-Pro pack. Let's see what we can get out of this All-Pro pack. There's supposed to be two goals. So Brandon Albi, that's a pretty decent start. All 83s are good right now just because I can sell them for a good amount. Anything in the 80s is good because I can sell them for a decent amount. Mercedes Lewis, hopefully that's not our only gold. Okay, we got a few more. Luke Jokel. Don't think we're going to get any more golds. We got lucky with three there. That's not too bad of a pack, though. We got a Brandon Albert, a Lewis, and a Jokel. How many coins do we have? We only have 250 coins at the moment. So I'm going to have to... Gonna have to purchase some packs eventually here. I don't really want to do any of them right now. Let's see what else we can do in here. I don't think we can do really much else. But yeah, pretty cool. We got that Odell Beckham to start. Yeah, I can't really do anything else. I guess next time when I come back, I'm going to be opening a ton of packs. And that's how we're going to get this Madden PlayStation series started. I think I might actually do this in this episode. I might just cut it off right now. And then I'll come right back and we're going to start tearing some packs and see how we can do on the PS1 or PS4. So be right back, guys. And yeah, we'll cut to that. So welcome back, guys. I just added a ton of points. And I think we're going to open that 40-pack bundle. I feel like that's the most smart one to do at this point. It's going to give us lots of jerseys and stuff like that we can sell. Give us a chance at some leads. Because remember, we opened like 30 packs or something like that on Xbox. I think it was maybe a couple more, maybe like 34 or something. And we got a couple elites, so if we can repeat that, that would be awesome. So this will be a kind of a longer video since we have a lot of packs to go here. And we just gotta hope we can get some good things. High 80s, stuff like that. Not necessarily elites. I will take like 82s, 83s, 84s, because they are worth a good amount on the auction block. Even some of these silver players are still pretty good, just because I can sell them for a couple thousand, stuff like that, just because they're in sets. I just need something to be able to start off so I can boost my coins. And if we can get any elites or any legends, that would be awesome. Okay, 84, Rodney Hudson, that's not too bad. He's got to be worth a decent amount. Yeah, that's a pretty good pull so far. Any 80s is what we're looking for. If we happen to pull a Rod Woodson or anything crazy, that would be amazing. Elvis Dumer, that's another great one there, because he's probably going for a good 4,000 or 5,000. So he almost makes, with everything else we have in this pack, he probably makes that pack worthwhile. We'll go to the next one here. Anything in the 80s basically will help the pack pay for itself. Low 70s aren't that good. But when we get two in one pack, that's pretty good. The Mathis will probably go for a good 3,000 or 4,000 as well. So that's not too bad. And you gotta remember, each one of these offenses and stuff like that, coaches, that's maybe 300 or 400, hopefully. Hussein Abdullah. Just gotta get lucky and get some elites here. Also get lucky and get some 2-for-1 packs. We only got one so far with two golds in it. Let's go backwards this time, but it's already at the front. 80 fullback, that's not too bad. I don't think fullbacks will be worth that much, though. But we got 2-in-1 Nick Perry, that's not too bad. Whenever you get 2-in-1, even if they aren't high 80s, I'll take it. $75, that's not too good. That pack kind of sucked right there. Still have yet to see elite. I wouldn't mind any elite collectibles or anything like that as well. Quentin Damps. These are cards I don't want to see right here, just because they might as well just quick sell them here, because I can't do anything with anything with any of the cards that aren't on a team, just because they aren't in any sets, so they aren't really that valuable. So if I do see them, I'm probably just going to discard them. I'm sorry if I can sell them for a little bit more. It's just Kiko Alonso, that's actually a pretty good card. He probably is going for a decent amount because he does have pretty good stats. Still have yet. How many packs? Let's just back out of here and see how many packs we've gone through here. I'm going to go all the way out. We still have 100 points. 100 points really isn't anything, though. Unopened packs. Still got 30. So that was the first 10. We didn't really get anything worthwhile there, though. That's a terrible start to this pack. We did get two golds, though. We got a Gabe Jackson at the end there. We need some elites. Elites are going to help so much, because I can quickly get rid of them and make a good amount of coins and get everything started here. Come on. Just want to see a legend one of these times, and I will cry. John Brown. It's not terrible. We gotta start mixing up. We gotta go backwards now. This is not working out. Another Elvis Dumer. We got two Elvises. I hope he's worth a decent amount. I hope he's worth about a good 4,000 or 5,000 on the auction block. How many sets is he in? He's only in one, but he's in the captain set, so he's got to be worth a good amount. And most of these silvers and bronzes are in sets too, so their value might be around 1,000, or even some of them might be a bit more rare. Especially when a player's in more than one sets, like two sets, they might still be a little more valuable too. So even though these aren't the greatest cards, I can sell them. Terrence Seiden, that's still not too bad. Love to see some elites, though. I've probably already jinxed myself, though, unfortunately. Just gonna see what we can get, see what man's gonna give us on day one, Leotis McKelvin. Okay, two, Shane Leckler, that's not too bad. I always take two golds in a pack, because that's at least, might make me a little bit. James Starks, not getting enough high 80s, though. Not really getting much of anything. We're gonna have a lot of like sellable collectibles and stuff like that. Stadiums. This card is useless. Might as well take the 100 coins. Sports Authority Field, which is cool. That'll be my stadium. Okay, first elite CJ Mosley. Awesome. That's actually a pretty decent elite because I love CJ Mosley. He's got good speed. Look at that, 94 tackle, 95 pursuit, 90 play recognition, 84 block shedding, 84 hit power. That's a pretty good card. He's got plus 9 run stuffing, run stop. Yeah, I'll take that as my first elite. I can't complain. Any elites, that's probably a good 20 or 30,000 for that card right there, so I'll definitely take it. Especially, okay, Legends Badge. Okay, I don't even know what these are worth. This unique badge can be used towards unlocking some of the greatest players in Legend history. So I can auction it, so I'm kind of curious. I haven't even seen a Legends Badge. I don't think I saw any on Xbox auction block. I guess they must be out there. I'm kind of curious what they're worth now. Let's actually, I kind of want to go do research now, because I'm curious what that Legends Badge is worth. I haven't seen any of them, so I don't know what I should say the value of that is. This is my first time checking out the auction block here. So we'll search Legend Badge. It should be called that. It's not called, is it called Legends? I think it's called Legends. Okay, I understand. Legends Badge, ooh. Okay, that's a good 20,000. Awesome. So two elites. We might as well check out the CJ Mosley, honestly, while we're here, see what he's going for. So that's 20,000, which is awesome. I spell it's CJ, right? It's CJ Mosley, correct? Maybe I'm just search. It's finding something right now. It's not. Let's just search Mosley. See if we can hunt him down. There should definitely be some on the auction block, so. And there we go. I see one for 21. So cheapest, what do we got? Cheapest is 20. So yeah, that's a good 20,000. Maybe 19 or 18. Let's go keep opening packs. So we already got two elites. So we'll value that at about 40,000 coins, which isn't too bad through half the packs. Again, with all the collectibles we've gotten and all the little stuff, that's pretty damn good. There's lots of sellable stuff, so we probably have a good 80 or 90,000 worth of sellable items we've gotten so far, which definitely pays for it at this point. It's gonna take a while to sell everything, of course, but let's get some more 80s, some more 80s. I wouldn't mind some more badges too. I didn't even know those were pullable in these. I thought those were only in like the badge packs. That's good to see. Gotta remember, if I see these guys, just cut them. Just because they don't have any value to me whatsoever. 75 DeMonte Moore, not that great. Let's keep it going here. 75 Kyle Fuller. Kyle Fuller is not that bad of a player in Madden. So not getting too lucky here, but we already got the two elites, which is good. If we didn't pull any other elites, we probably could still easily sell everything for maybe 130,000, 140,000, depending on the value after I search everything. Right? Yeah. Brian Renner. John Fox. What does John Fox do? He's short pass. Last card. Lance Kendrick's not that great again. We got the CJ Mosley, which is awesome, though. If we could just pull a legend, though, that would be amazing, because the legends are a good 200,000. Depending on the legend, of course. Okay, Charles Clay, that's not too bad. Again, all 80s are good. Jahlil Adey, that's good, too. Any player at this point is good. Any gold player. Last card. Okay, Vinny Curry. Let's just back up quickly again. We're up to 11 packs, or 3/4 done. We still got a bit to go here, though. 11 packs, a lot can happen, and that's at least 11 gold or better players if I don't get any doubles. 83 Morgan Burnett. 83s are awesome. Morgan Burnett's a good 4,000 coin card. '82 Ron O'Leary, again, any 80s, especially when we get doubles in that too, that's even better, because that's that extra gold, it's like an extra 1,000 at least. Brendan Colquitt, what is Colquitt's kick power in this? He might actually be my punter. It's not that good in this compared to his in-game stats. Ryan Harris, I'll keep that Ryan Harris just because he is high enough, but he is a free agent, which isn't good. 8 packs to go. Okay, Ruben Rano, that's not too bad again. All these coaches, all these playbooks are all awesome too, because they're all worth something. CJ, okay, so that's a different CJ Mosley, actually. That's a D-tackle CJ. James Casey. Let's keep it going here. Chris Ivory. I think we already pulled a Chris Ivory before. So we must have like 4 or 5 packs left to go here. At least I think. Nice. Okay, let's just quickly go through this to make sure there's nothing else hidden. We got our second elite player, Whitworth. I think Whitworth is probably a good 30,000. I think he might be 25 or 30,000. But that's still an awesome card. 92 strength, 87 run block, 95 pass block, 86 impact blocking. Our second, actually, we'll consider him our third elite because we did get that badge, which is awesome as well. So nice. How many packs we got? We got 4 to go. You know, Rod Woods is in. Rod Woods in might be at the end here. You never know. Not looking good with that Demetrius McCray, though. Nothing hidden in there. Chris Houston. I'm not going to keep that Chris Houston just because he is a little lower down. He's probably not going to make my team as it is. But all these cards are sellable. I'll have to go through it myself after and just double check to see if I have any more free agents that I can cut for some quick coins and then price everything off and get it on the auction block and selling. Let's keep it going. 1 pack left here. I whimper. Ah, you're not making the team. I'm sorry, man. I'll take that 1,000 coins. I got my first 1,000 coins in this so far. It's going to be a lot more than that to come, though. Jeremy Curley ends it off. So not that. Like, it was pretty decent, honestly. Whitworth is pretty good. Mosley's pretty good. That legend badge, of course, is awesome. That's a good 20,000 as well. But nothing too extraordinary, but just a pretty standard packs. You know, that was... I can't complain, nor can I really gloat too much. So I guess that's it. I gotta do a lot of selling. How many cards? I have 463 cards. Damn. Let's say on average the cards are valued at, let's say 700. 700 times 100 would be, is that 70,000? That's about 70,000. And I have 400 cards, so we're looking at about 280,000. That's on average if I sell them for 700, because I know some of these silver players are worth more, some of the gold players are worth more than that. It's just a rough average. So I think we could easily get 200,000 at bare minimum out of everything we pulled today, which is pretty good for the $50 I spent to do all this, which is, yeah, it's pretty good. And that'll give us a good head start for future things like that. It'll give us enough coins that we can snipe on the auction block and do stuff like that. So yeah, and of course we did get a free Odell Beckham Jr., which is an awesome player to start up my team with and start wrecking some people in head-to-head seasons. So beyond that, guys, I hope you guys enjoyed. If you did, leave a like, and more pack openings to come, more just tons of little videos on the Ultimate Team. We're going to do sets. We're going to do everything this year. And yeah, peace out, guys. Thanks for watching.